Welcome, welcome, welcome back to On the Move. I'm your host, JoAnna Ward, and you are in the studio with us today at WATC 57 in Norcross. And you guys know that I was a college athlete, and basketball has been my game for a very long time. And I have a very special guest, two very special guests. I have the Camp of Champions founder, Daryl Battles, and his assistant with him today, Coach Roy. You guys come on up. They're gonna show us some things to do with the basketball.
Yay!
All right, Coach Roy.
Hi.
Oh, and they bought me a gift.
All right. All right, all right.
Okay, so before we get started, I'm going to get you to come in closer.
Okay.
We can make sure that everybody can see you guys okay. And this is actually Coach Daryl Battles, and this is Coach Roy. Coach Roy has been coaching children and in church leagues and in youth leagues.
Yes.
And he is a youthful 82 years old. And he's going to talk to us after this set about what you need to eat and what kind of life you need to live that you too can age well. And then Coach Daryl's going to tell us about the Camp of Champions.
That's right.
And how to be a champion.
That's
because you just won in a 55 and over basketball champion.
Yes,
so
I did.
So he's going to show us some stuff to try to get us moving. It's not going to be like what I do, but it's going to be some things you might be interested in because everybody loves basketball. Loves basketball. So we get a little bit of music just to kind of wake you up a little bit.
Okay, then. I got you. That'll work.
Okay. Tell us what we're doing now.
Well, what we're going to do is we're going to start out with just a few movements to get the juices flowing. As you can see, Mr. 82 years young right there, that's my inspiration. So what we're doing, especially in basketball, basketball requires a lot of movement with our joints that are going to be helpful with the activity, with the sport. So we just want to start out right foot on the band. Now all we're going to do is go to a... Is this close enough here?
Yeah.
All we're doing is keeping our balance, not locking your knees too tight.
Okay.
And just slowly coming up.
Turn your wrist over.
This helps work your shoulders, isn't it?
Oh, this make me look like I'm fit. Won't he do it?
Now also, get a little space.
Okay. Out to the side.
Mm-hmm.
So, Coach, what's this working for us right here?
This is going to work those shoulders.
Oh, my shoulders.
You know, this has helped because today's game has changed.
Really?
Yes, it has. It has transformed from the inside of the paint to way outside behind the three-point line.
So it's no more right at the three-point line.
No, not at the three-point line.
If you don't check somebody before when they get across half court, they pull it up.
The minute you cross half court, you better watch.
They pull it up, Coach Roy?
Yes.
That's it.
Wow. So you got to play defense pretty much.
That's it. Step through.
Mm-hmm.
Got a shoulder. All right. Quick shoulder press.
Oh.
Watch out.
Yeah, so this will help me.
Yes.
That's right. That's right. Face the camera.
Yeah, like that. I know, right?
I know it's tough. Yeah. I know it's tough. All right, and what you can also do is lower one side. Make sure you keep your foot planted. Yeah, you can drop it on the floor. There you go. Ooh. That's it.
Keep going.
Yeah, roll it up a little bit, Roy. Raise that foot up.
Yeah, now you got it. There you go.
Yeah, that's gonna mess it up.
There you go.
Yeah.
Oh. Just go straight up.
Ooh. And this actually helps.
Right? That's something, right?
Yeah, this helps that three-point shot.
Three-pointer?
Yes.
Oh, snap. I used to just be a threat in the paint. They getting ready to get it now. You telling me this right here is going to help me be able to pull up from the three-point?
Beyond the three-point line.
Trust me. I'm going to tell y'all something right now. I go hard in the paint, but I stay away from them long shots. You know, they don't reach for me.
All right, you can switch sides. Go to the left side.
So D showing me how to get ready. So stay ready so I don't have to get ready.
Works on the tricep. Oh, yes. Oh, yes.
You know what? This is.
Get your foot up.
Yeah, roll it up.
There you go.
I won't. Go ahead.
Right here.
All right. Yeah. You can do a few of these.
Yeah.
That ball.
Oh, so I'm going to be able to shoot like that.
That's right. That's right. You know, and we have to be ambidextrous these days.
Oh, you can't just be right-handed no more?
You can't be right-handed.
They'll lock you down. They'll play you all day and shut you down.
Completely down.
Once I find out you're one-handed, you're done with me. All right, what
we
gonna do?
Are we done with the bands?
Yeah, we're done with the bands right now. What we're gonna do is do a few exercises with the ball and with the kids. The kids, what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna actually do a figure eight.
Okay.
Now, everybody all over the room, open your mouth and worship. I'm gonna pass it to you, Joe, and I want you to pass it to Mr. Coach Roy, all right?
Okay.
Figure eight. And all we're doing is figure eight. Figure eight. Then you do the figure eight, pass it back.
All right.
Oh, I see what you're saying. You want us to flow with it.
Yeah. Right.
Just flow it through your legs. Let me know when you're ready to pass. There you go. And this actually helps the quads because we are squatting down a little bit. Oh, I love it. I love it. My, yes, yes.
My hallelujah belongs to you.
This helps the squat, and this actually is a good exercise to help with defense.
Oh, yeah, I see
that. We're training the kids.
Uh-huh.
I get 8, 10-year-old coaching my back. And the boy, you don't know where your back is.
All right, come your way, coach.
All right. Now we're going to do single leg. So with your left leg. Left leg. And we have them do the exercise without the ball so they can get the movement.
Hallelujah, Lord, to you.
Get it, coach. Get it, coach.
Hallelujah.
Still on the left, coach, right? Coming back?
Still on the left. Still on the left.
All right, coming to you.
Now we're gonna do the right. As we become more advanced with the kids during the training, as you can see, my head is watching the ball.
Yeah.
Because I'm trying to motivate them as well.
Right.
Because it's no fun when you flip the ball, you got to up.
Oh.
You deserve it.
It's no fun. So we keep motivated by looking at the ball, finding it first.
Okay.
Passing.
Looking at the ball. Come at you, Coach Roy.
Come on up.
All of the glory belongs to you.
Get it, coach. Look at coach. Coach took it behind his back, coach. He took it behind his back. Thank you. Coming to you, coach.
I got you. Thank you. And now, around both legs. Remember, we're still squatting down.
Okay.
All right, coming to you.
You deserve it.
Legs together, legs together, Coach Roy, legs together. There you go. I like that. That's good.
Oh, my Lord.
That's good. Yeah, see, you got fancy with it. Good job, Joe.
Thank you.
Now, we're going clockwise.
Clockwise?
Now, we're going clockwise. There you go. Clockwise. Boy, I tell you. Go ahead. All right.
Hallelujah.
All right now.
Hallelujah.
All right now. So now we can go around the waist.
All the praise.
Oh, man.
Waist.
Hand, waist, bands, dang.
This helps you get the feel for the basketball.
Yeah. So you don't be fumbling them.
That's right. So you don't cause any turnovers.
I hate turnovers.
You don't cause any turnovers.
My coach made us run every time we did a turnover.
That's it.
How many are we gonna get?
Around the head, around the waist. There you go.
Am I going the right direction?
You go, hey, it doesn't
go the other way? Okay.
Yeah, man.
Hallelujah.
There you go.
Hallelujah. All the glory. All the honor.
Let's see if we can put them all together right quick.
Okay.
You deserve it.
Yo, go.
So you said we're doing section
all
eight first.
Figure eight.
And then single leg.
Single leg.
Leg. Round the waist.
Round the head.
Ah, we got one more. Gotta get that clothes leg. Figure eight.
Oh, the clothes leg, okay.
Round the waist.
Call it out now,
round the head. All right, flip it out. There you go. Good job, coach. Good job.
Okay, call it out, coach.
Single leg, figure eight.
I mean, it's a single leg on both sides?
Figure eight first.
Figure eight, okay.
Single leg left.
Single leg left.
Single leg right.
Single leg right.
Double leg, leg together.
Oh, that's the one I missed.
That's it. Now, round the waist, round the head. All right, good job. Let's see if I can do it.
Okay.
Single leg left.
Uh-huh. Right.
Single leg right.
Okay.
Figure eight.
Together. Oh, figure eight.
Double leg. Waist. Head. Ooh. All right, good job. Good job. Good job.
Y'all now, pass him.
Now, we're going to do a couple quick passes, Cole. Okay. Couple quick passes. Step to me. All we want to do is step with the basketball. We don't want to leave somebody out.
It's there all three of us. There?
Yes, ma'am. Yes. Single pass. And one thing about with basketball, this is a great exercise.
Exercise. So this is what we're doing.
This is it. This is a great exercise. All you're doing is moving. Realize we got, now we're going to go overhead.
Overhead, okay.
Yep. It's a great exercise. And see, what are we doing?
Hand-eye coordination.
We haven't shot
reflex.
The ball one time.
No,
one,
we have reflex. Not.
There you go. See, and that's what's happening now in schools. Everybody go in the gym, they looking for the basketball hoops.
They don't want to play defense?
Nah, they don't want to play defense.
Shooting three,
that's it.
Nobody's posting up, nobody getting any rebounds.
All right, now we're going to do baseball.
Baseball
pass.
Oh.
That's it.
Oh, I used to get those when I would take off down the court.
Oh, so you were that snowbird, huh?
Yeah, I mean, if I be there, you know I'm fast now.
That's it.
I run down there.
Good job. Now, the last pass will be a bounce pass, but we're not going to do that one.
You can.
I don't know if that ball got aired it.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
My coach said, get hit it right by the feet so nobody don't steal it.
That's it.
Back at you, Coach Roy. Uh-oh.
All right, now, what I want to do, Roy, I'm going to do a couple of exercises on the floor with the basketball. And this actually helps the shot.
Oh,
did you notice?
The spinning.
You're right. You gotta find the rotation. If you notice, my feet are up.
Mm-hmm.
Some people do this, some people lay flat. I'd rather have my feet up, because what are we working? What are we working, Coach JoAnna?
Our lower and upper
my feet
abs.
Up. There you go. If you notice, my rotation is off. My rotation is off. The ball should go up.
Yeah.
Come straight back to me.
And it should be spinning.
Should be spinning.
Lord, thank you, Lord.
There you go.
Nice. But he's working his abs while keeping his eye in coordination. And he has his head up, so that's working
right.
His entire abs, the lower and the upper. Right, Coach Roy?
Yes.
Right.
So you guys can do what Coach D is doing at home, at work, anywhere. And they can do this without a basketball, right?
Yes.
But people just love basketball. It's kind of a motivator.
That's right.
And if they want to prepare for their game, they can do that too. So
right. Thank
you so much, Coach Daryl from Kappa Champions.
All right.
And Coach Roy, y'all did that.
Thank you.
I had such a... ball.
Thank you.
Because, you know, I went back
too.
In town. Oh, yeah. My air conditioner come on quick. But hey, we're going to go get cleaned up we're going to come back and we're going to talk to these coaches about how to stay fit and stay alive and keep going long after you think you can. You guys, stay tuned and come right back. We're going to talk to Coach D and Coach Roy right after this break. Welcome back. We have gotten cleaned up. You know, you guys, we were sweating and running with basketballs and with Coach Roy. But now we're going to talk about what you guys saw on those shirts, the Camp of Champions, which is a champions camp for boys and girls that Coach Daryl Battles has. Coach D, thank you for coming back. And thank you for cleaning up so well.
Thank you very much.
Absolutely amazing.
Nice to see you again.
Oh, thank you.
Yes.
So look, tell us about Camp of Champions and how you got it started. Like,
well,
where did you get it from?
The Camp of Champions actually came from the very first scholarship I was awarded coming out of high school. The junior college, they offered me a summer job.
Mm-hmm.
And the program was called the NYSP, which was the National Youth Sports Program.
Okay.
And I loved it. The director, he had a heart after God. And it was so hard for him. We were only... program licensed to have 500 kids. Mm-hmm. And somehow he would have 600 to 625 every summer. And I'm trying to figure out, and then when we get audited, right, they would come and they would only count 500 kids. And I would talk to, you know, Pastor Chapman, how did you do it? He said, hey, look at God.
Five flows and two fish,
that's it. So when I started in junior college, each summer I would work the camp. And it just put a, and I knew God was working with me then because I realized I wanted to work with kids. And having a professional career, being blessed to have a professional career after attending Southern University, the Southern University, the only HBCU there is. But anyway, that's
right,
another subject.
Okay.
But we
we didn't get that memo, but okay.
And on my way back, I was this was 1998. On my way back, I was playing in Israel. Mm-hmm. I had lived in Israel for 3 seasons, and on my way back, there were three kids, and they were a little rambunctious, and you know, a long flight coming from Tel Aviv, Israel, flying to New York, you're talking about 18 hours. Mm-hmm. And I could see the faces on people, and I was literally sitting about 2 seats from them.
Yeah.
So I glanced over at the dad, and the mom looked, and I caught their eye, and I said, can I talk to them? And they were like, please do. So I switched seats with both the mom and dad. Uh-huh. So they took the seat, and the guy that was next to me, he said, I'll give them my seat too. And so I sat with them, and we just had nice conversations all the way. And I told them, I said, we're gonna do this, 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 this. We watched a movie, you know, because that's a long flight.
Right.
So we watched a movie, we ate dinner, then they went to sleep. They woke up, watched a movie, ate breakfast, and as we were entering to the airspace, you know, of course, the flight attendants, they turned the lights on. I stand up to get my bag, and everybody started clapping. And I'm looking around like, I'm clapping too, I'm glad we made it back. And it's like, no, that's not what they're clapping.
Yeah.
They're clapping because they noticed those three kids were gonna be a problem. And somehow you allowed them and you talked with them, and they were not a problem at all. Even the mom and dad, come to find out, the husband was one of the directors. He was on the board for the Jewish Community Center.
Really?
Yes, he was.
Father of those children. Wow.
And he pursued me for several years because he wanted me to come over and be their athletic director in the off season. And God specifically spoke to me and said, I want you to do it where I want you to do it. And that was not where it was supposed to be done.
Oh, wow.
So I ended up starting the Camp of Champions in 1999. So we're in our 24th year.
Almost a quarter of a century.
Yes, yes. Don't remind me.
I mean, it's just a matter of how you see it. Either
yes,
it's aging like fine wine or it's rotten like fruit.
I'd rather take the aging like fine wine. I'll take that.
The longevity, the endurance, the ability to do that and still be doing it. But it started there.
That's where it started.
So it started there. How's it going now?
It's going great.
It's going great.
Right now, we're in our second week of summer camp.
Okay.
And we have about 40 kids registered. Mm-hmm. And tomorrow we have our first field trip. Mm-hmm. Now, I want you to pray for me tonight, okay?
In the name of Jesus.
Yes, because we're taking them on the road.
Where are you guys going?
We're going to the movies.
Really?
Yeah, they voted to see Transformers.
Okay. I heard it's pretty good.
I haven't seen it, so don't.
I said I heard.
Okay, you heard. Okay, mm-hmm. then. Yeah, so we'll be going on our first field trip. Of the summer. So mm-hmm. I'm looking forward to it. And I always give the kids a break because they come in and they are really working hard.
Mm-hmm. You know? So tell us about a day in the camp.
Well, we open the doors at 7 a.m.
Right.
And, you know, I have some parents that are waiting in the parking lot. And I'm like, it's 6:45.
Can we give you an extra $50 to open at 6?
And I'm like, it's 6:45. And then now, because we just decided to come and wait for you. I'm like, yeah, not really. Made me think I need to give you guys keys. So we open up at 7. We have breakfast at 8, between 8 and 9. That's included with the camp fee. All meals are included with our camp fee.
Okay.
And we have opening discussion and opening prayer at 9. And what I like to do is I call on any kid any time of the day, and I just tell them, you pray about what you want to pray about.
Okay.
I say it doesn't have to be 10 minutes. It doesn't have to be 2 seconds. It just has to be coming from your heart.
Right.
You know, and some of the kids are a little apprehensive. Coach, I've never prayed. I say, but it's okay. It's okay. Whatever comes out of your mouth, guess what happened? God's going to hear it.
Amen.
Yeah. And at between 9 and 11:30, we have what's called individual skills and drills training.
Mm-hmm.
That's where we work on everything from ball handling to proper foot technique to shooting technique to defensive stance. And we do
at 11:30, this is my favorite part. We have devotional reading. And it's amazing what these kids can get out of the Bible.
Okay.
Yep. So for 30 minutes, we have devotional reading. 12 o'clock, we have lunch from 12 to 1.
So who does the devotional? The children by leader, or is an adult that leads them in the...
Actually, the adults, you know, I like to lead the pastor of the church that we're at now. Okay. He will come in from time to time.
Okay.
You know, so, but some of the older boys who I've been with for, who's been with me 10 years now, they understand what that time means, you know. So, you know, we laugh, but they understand, okay, now we're getting a little more serious when it comes to the time of the day that coaches set aside.
So let me ask you something. You talked about prayer and them praying from their hearts, and now you're talking about devotional. And it's not church, right? So how does this age on a kid, or how does this age on a person? What part of their lives, why is this even significant or important for you to have prayer in a devotional? Like, where does that play a role? Because right now, people don't believe it plays a role. So they don't do it, and then we end up in a different place. So tell me what that, you know, why you're infusing that in your program.
Over the past, before I retired from playing professional basketball, and before I started my program, I would work at different camps throughout different summers. And I just felt they were leaving something out because it was all about just bouncing a ball. And I'm always thinking, well, what happened to that total child? I wanted to deal with the total student athlete, that total child. And we're talking about mind, body, and soul. And if you mention those three parts, you know, the Holy Spirit covers all three of those. And so when you say why is it significant, I think it's important because I want to have a relationship with God, and I do have one. And I want them to understand that they can have one. I'm not forcing it down their throats, but I'm allowing them the opportunity to seek God for themselves.
And so why is that important to you?
It's important that
they even have such a thing, not necessarily just going to church, doing a devotional, doing a prayer, but that you said something very powerful and profound at once, a relationship with God.
Right. Why is it important to me?
And for you, not just for you, because some people are like, I got it, you on your own. But you're making this a priority in your program. Why do you think that this is going
to
be?
Because I know it's what God called me to do.
Okay.
It's my purpose. And I'm not wavering on it. I know that's my purpose in life.
You know that.
I know that.
You go to sleep on it, and you wake up on it. You're staying on your 10 and your 2, and that's just what it is. And it doesn't matter what nobody say.
Yes, ma'am.
And you know that you're giving the kids a safety net. I call it a spiritual safety net.
There you go.
Because we are, like you said, if it's not bouncing the ball, it's working a job. It's building a marriage. It's building it's all these other things. Right. And then the soul and the spirit is neglected. And that's what I think you're doing. You're infusing a spiritual vitamin into these kids.
Thank you.
That I think that they're going to be able to use for decades. I know it to be true. And so I just wanted to add that to the audience, and they probably were asking the same question.
Thank you.
So how does the day end at Camp of Champions?
Well, the day ends, we have, after lunch, you know, now we have to wake everybody back up. So we have this, and the kids love it. They play dodgeball.
Oh, really? With a basketball?
No. They're softball.
Okay.
Trust me, they're softballs. And that can go on for 30, 45 minutes to an hour. I have the little Bowler Wilson say, okay, that's enough, guys, because they love it. And they don't realize they're working on their agility. They're working on their reaction time. And I said, they don't understand that that's still an exercise.
Right.
It's different than Coach blowing the whistle and say, let's do a suicide. But if I give you a dodgeball, you will run around the gym trying to dodge those balls all afternoon.
And hit people.
You get to hit people, and people get to hit you.
Right.
And after that, we go back to, now it's team building exercises.
Okay.
The first part of the day is more about the individual. Now we try to put it together in the second part of the day to let them know there are 5 players on the team.
Right.
So it's 5 against 5. It's never one-on-one. And I ask them all the time, you know, when have you seen a high school game where it was one guy against one? And they said, no, it's never.
Never.
So you have to understand how to play. You know, so we're teaching them positioning on the court. We're teaching them how to help on defense. We're teaching them, you know, certain moves, pick and rolls, you know, how to read the defense. And even at 7 or 8 years old, they're picking up on it. You know, so, and I think when they get to middle school and high school, they will have the foundation that they need. And that's going to help them be a great team player.
So let me ask you, those parents that get there early, do they get there late, or do they get there on time?
You just named it. Yes. Yes, I have some parents who will 5:59, maybe pushing the button. Some will come and just park in the parking lot and wait, because we have closing prayer at 5.
Okay.
5 p.m., we close for the day, but okay. We ask they not be picked up after 6.
Okay.
Some of the parents will literally sit in the park a lot.
And just let them have that extra hour.
Yeah.
Let you have that extra hour.
Yeah, let me have that extra hour. Right. And they come here at 5:59. Coach, is this camp over? Yeah, camp was over at 5 o'clock.
Right, but it's not
a problem, though.
Not a problem. You enjoy it because you love what you do.
I love it.
You've put in purpose with your passion, and hopefully it's causing them to prosper, and you prosper. Well, so if I had a son that young, which I don't, praise God, thank you, Jesus, hallelujah, glory to God. But if I did, okay. And this was 20 years ago, and I wanted to sign him up, how would I do that?
Well, you could actually, we have on-site,
okay.
You know, because I've realized sometimes having a website, mm-hmm. people can go, they can look at the pictures. Mm-hmm. I want them to come in the building and see
makes sense.
Who's actually working with your child. Because I've had some people who have, they've gone, and especially in that month of March and April,
yeah.
when school is about to dismiss, mm-hmm. so they're rushing trying to put their kids someplace. They will register online with another program, and after 1 week, guess what happens?
They come back.
They're coming over here to me.
Mm-hmm.
And so I've looked at it, well, come into the building
makes sense.
You can see Coach Roy, you can see Coach Desmond Rush, who's been an international trainer for a long time.
Mm-hmm.
You can see Ms. Roxanne, my assistant, and you can meet me.
Right.
And you can meet two college students that I've been working with since they were 5 and 6.
I like it.
Now they're in college.
I like it.
Come back home to give back.
Because I would want to know who if from 7 to 6 every day for the
there
summer, definitely want to know and meet those people, shake their hands, let them make sure they know me, what I stand for as a parent. I think that's an awesome idea.
Thank you.
So your contact information is going to be shared with our viewers.
Yes.
And hey, you know, you guys heard from Coach D himself. This is Daryl Battles, the founder and the CEO, CFO, president
of
Camp of Champions. You can sign up with him directly. This ain't no online stuff here.
Thank you.
You celebrate celebrities. You need to celebrate coaches, counselors, teachers, and those people to work with kids every day. You've been on the move with Coach Daryl Battles and JoAnna Ward. We'll see you guys next time.